Hi, it's Kiana Miner. I am so excited today. This is the third video in our series, How to Live a VIP Life. I am just receiving so much positive feedback in the comments and emails and messages that you're sending me. Just excited about this information and telling me how much this information is already impacting your life. It's amazing. Once we decide that we're going to live more courageously, once we decide that we're going to be our authentic selves and share our gifts with the world, it's really amazing how inspired we feel. Today, we're going to take a deep dive into one of the 7 steps to living your VIP life. And if you've been with me through all 3 videos, then you know that the VIP life is the life that makes you feel alive. It's the life where you're giving your gifts and you're living your passion and you feel so fulfilled. There's no replacement for living the VIP life. And so we're going to take a deep dive into one of the steps to living your VIP life. I really want to focus on this step in this video because this is the step that stops so many people from living the life of their dreams. It stops them from achieving their goals. This step really stops people before they even really get started. So I really want to dive into this step. I know that this is going to unlock some great potential in everyone watching, and it's just going to make you feel even more alive once you know how to implement this step. But first, let's do a little bit of catch up and review the information that we discussed in the last 2 videos. And also, I want to share some comments and answer some questions that's come in since the last video. So in the first video, we talked about what is the VIP life. It's the vortex of infinite potential. It's all that's possible for you in your life. And we talked about why we want to explore our potential as far as creating a life that we really want to live, that we deserve to live, and that makes us feel alive. I shared my story in the first video, and I received so much positive feedback about that story because this story is the story of so many of you. It's the story of so many of us. We start out in life wanting to live our passion, wanting to really be authentic and really live these beautiful and poetic and inspiring lives. But something happens along the way, and we're told that we can't have it all, that we can either make a living or we can either have a living and have a life, but we can't have both. And I got that message loud and clear, and I started living a paper perfect life. I had a good job, I had a good relationship, I had all these good things in my life. I had good pay and my bills were paid on time every month, and that was enough for me. But honestly, it really wasn't enough because deep down inside, I had the yearning for something more. I really wanted to live this life that inspired me and that inspired other people. And that was me giving my gifts to the world and living my life's purpose. And so eventually, I was able to quit my job and really live my passion. And I was able to have it all. I could pay my bills and I could give gifts to the world of inspiration and encourage other people to be their best selves. So I know this is the story of so many people, and I'm glad that it inspired you. In the second video, I really dove deep into how do you live the VIP life? What are the 7 steps to get you from living this paper-perfect life that leaves you feeling unfulfilled to living a life that fills you up in every way, that is passionate and that is amazing? Every day you wake up just knowing that you're living the life you were born to live. So these 7 steps get you from the plan B to the VIP life. And you know, I've received so much great feedback about those steps too, and that people were already starting to implement them. So congratulations. So thank you so much for being with me for all 3 videos. Today we're going to take a deep dive into one of those 7 steps. But let me share with you one question that I got from the previous videos. And this question is, when planning, how much planning is too much planning? And I really wanted to answer that question because I believe when any of you have a question, that it represents the thoughts of many of you. And so this person was just brave enough to ask this question. I really wanted to answer it. And when it comes to planning, planning is important. In fact, it's one of the key 7 steps to living your VIP life. However, planning can also be used to hold us back and to make us procrastinate. We plan and we plan and we plan, and we never take that leap and we never jump. So my advice to you would be, go ahead and put your plan together and decide what it is you need to do. And I actually have a worksheet. If you go back to video 2, I created a worksheet that answers this question very well. But and that helps you put your plan together. But go ahead and put your plan together, but make sure that your plan has actionable steps and that you're actually taking action and taking steps, and then put dates by each of those actionable steps. So okay, I have to take this action in order to make my dream happen. And I'm gonna take this action by this date, and map that out for all the actions you need to take that grand leap of faith. That way you know that you're constantly moving, you're building momentum, and you're getting to where you want to be. So I hope that answers your question. I hope that answers the question of so many people at home who are thinking for themselves, okay, I have a plan, but how do I make sure that this plan leads to my dream life? So hope that answers your question. Okay, now it's time to dive deep into one of the 7 key steps to living your VIP life. And the step we're gonna discuss today is healing. Healing is a key step to living your VIP life. Healing is all about making sure that there's nothing, no pain that you've experienced in your past, no disappointments, no people that you need to forgive, nothing in your past really holding you back from living your dream life. So many times the voices in our heads can be our biggest enemy. It can be the biggest obstacle to living the life you've always dreamed of living. I've spent years as a massage therapist, as a healer, as a coach and a counselor, talking to people as they told me their deepest fears and the highest dreams they have for their life. And you know what? A lot of times our fears can come from our past. They come from our childhood and our upbringing. They come from the disappointments and the pain that we've experienced in our lives. And these fears can hold us back more than any person, more than any outside obstacle. They can hold us back from living the life we know we deserve to live. So I wanted to give you a process. I have another great worksheet for you. You know, I love worksheets because I believe when you put pen to paper, you start to really work out what you want your dream life to look like. You bring it out of the sky, out of your dreams, out of your head, and you start to put it into life. And so when you write things down, you're that much closer to living the life that you deserve. And so I have this worksheet. It's Kiana Miner's Crazy Courage Worksheet. And this worksheet really helps you to define what are the top 3 things holding you back. So if you can, just take a moment, download this worksheet. I have a link to it below, and print it out. And you want to have it with you as we go through this segment. So the first thing you want to do is you want to define a small personal goal you'd like to achieve in the next 90 days. Now we can use this also for larger goals, but this is, if by choosing a small goal, you're going to start to build your courage momentum. You're going to start to build your courage muscle. So choose one goal that you want to achieve in the next 90 days. Choose something that's actually achievable. So don't say become a lawyer or become a doctor, because that's something you can't achieve in the next 90 days unless you're already in school and about to graduate. But don't choose a small goal that you know that you can achieve. Choose something that's still a little challenging, but that you're capable of achieving in the next 90 days. Next, I want you to list your 3 top fears, objections, and excuses that are keeping you from this goal. So when you think about this goal, maybe this goal is to eat healthier. Maybe it's to wake up earlier so that you can start to work on that book that you know you want to write, or work on that the next artistic masterpiece that you're working on. Maybe you want to start waking up at 6 o'clock in the morning. Whatever your goal is, what are the top 3 things that keep you from this goal? And I'm going to tell you some of the top things that keep us from any goal, which is I don't have time and I don't have the money. So if those are one of your excuses, go ahead and write that down, because trust me, they are just excuses. We all have the same amount of time in the day, and money is a lot easier to acquire than you might think. So go ahead and write down your top 3 excuses. Next, what we're going to do is write down 3 affirmations, one for each excuse, to counteract that excuse. I believe that our excuses are really just beliefs. Our fears are really just beliefs that we have that hold us back from achieving all that's possible in our lives. Every time I've ever achieved anything great, when I started my own business, when I made over $100,000 my first year in business, when I wrote my book, everything I've ever achieved, even when I got married and had children, I had to start that achievement by changing my beliefs. Because when you believe something, When you believe your excuses, when you believe in your fears, they will hold you back and they will be the number one thing stopping you from achieving the life that you want. So you may think, you know, your beliefs are no big deal, but we achieve according to what we believe. We achieve according to what we constantly tell ourselves every day. So many times we'll complain that we don't have the support that we need in our lives to accomplish what we want to accomplish. Who is the person talking to you the most? Who is the person you spend the most time with? Yourself. So support yourself. You really need to support yourself and love yourself into a space of achieving everything you want to achieve. So let's take your top three fears, objections, and excuses, and let's turn them around. So I don't have time becomes I have the perfect amount of time to achieve everything I want to achieve. I don't have the money turns into I have unlimited resources to achieve my goals. I have money coming in from unexpected sources to help me achieve my goals. And, you know, whatever your third excuse is. So every excuse you have, turn it around and turn it into a positive so that you can start to shift your beliefs and you can stop being the one to hold yourself back. Okay, next I have this worksheet. And these are both in the same file. This is just the second page. This worksheet talks about the six-step mindset shift. And this six-step mindset shift is how you turn your negative fears and objections and beliefs into positive affirmations that will move you forward instead of holding you back. So this process is, the first thing you want to do is you want to read out loud the first negative fear, objection, or excuse that you put on this page. Read that item out loud. So if it's, I don't have time to achieve my goals. You will say, I don't have time to achieve my goals. And then I want you to say out loud, stop. So you're telling that belief, you're sending a signal to your brain to stop that belief. I want you to take a deep breath. So by breathing, by taking deep breaths, we tap into the vortex of infinite potential. So you take a deep breath. Let your belly fill up. Exhale. And this resets your nervous system. It cleanses out this belief after you say stop. And then I want you to say the new affirmation that corresponds to that fear or that belief. So I have enough time. I have more than enough time to achieve my goals. And then you repeat this process until the emotion associated with the fear subsides. So when we have a belief, when we have a fear, we may fill this fear with conviction. I really don't have time. I really don't have time. And you may feel very emotional about that fear. And so you want to repeat this process until you can say, I really don't have time. And it's almost like you're high, right? You're high off of your own breath. You're high off of your own potential for your life. You almost feel just like totally relaxed. Like you just finished getting a massage, you just finished drinking a glass of red wine, and you feel totally relaxed, and you want to repeat this process until you can say that fear and no emotion comes up and you don't feel like it's true for you anymore. And then you repeat this whole process for each of the three negative beliefs. Now this is a very powerful process, and I hope that you understood. If anything I just said sounds confusing, just read it. Read the process and repeat it and do it. And you'll feel the power in it. You'll feel that your life starts to shift. You'll feel like your beliefs are starting to shift. And it's an amazing process. And I do this every time I need to break through. Every time I need to release what's holding me back and step into the newness of my life. With this mindset shift really helps to align the right side of our brains toward our goals. It helps to heal. It helps you to release the past. It helps you to step into your new life. The action plan is more left brain. So this is more logic. We want to incorporate our new belief into the fabric of our lives, into the logic, into the action steps of our lives. And so the action plan has three steps. So the first step of the action plan is I want you to get an image that accurately portrays your goal. So if your goal is to finish your book in the next 90 days, then I want you to design, just roughly design a book cover that you can look at every day to know that your book is complete. In the mind of your imagination, your book is complete, and so that your actions will rise to meet that. When we have an image of what we want to achieve, our brains work better with images than they do with words. Images are the natural way in which we communicate. There's a Chinese saying that says a picture is worth 1,000 words. And I believe that is absolutely true. One picture can motivate you in ways that words can't. So you want to get an image that represents your goal, and you want to put it somewhere where you can see it every day. The second thing I want you to do is I want you to choose a physical activity. I want you to ingrain in your body that you are striving for something new, that you are recreating your life. And so I want you to choose a physical activity that doesn't require anything that you don't already have. In fact, it doesn't require anything outside of your home. You must be able to do this very conveniently with what you already have so that you don't use it as a tool to procrastinate. But I want you to do an activity for at least 5 minutes a day. And you may be thinking, what is 5 minutes going to do? But when you start to move and envision what it is that you want to achieve, you start to ingrain it into your body. And so this is what this process is doing. It's ingraining in your body what you want to achieve so that your body will keep moving, even if your mind tries to stop you and your mind is fearful. The third thing you want to do is make one simple change in your daily routine that will support your goal. So if you want to wake up in the morning, one thing you can change in your daily routine is you can go to bed earlier. Or if you want to be healthier, you can drink more water. Drink a cup of water first thing in the morning. It is all about implementing small changes to help you accomplish big goals. So if we implement small changes, then the small changes kind of don't freak us out, right? We can do small changes, and we allow the small changes to slowly build on themselves and slowly build and become bigger and bigger changes and create the snowball effect until one day we look up and our lives have changed. And so this is a technique that I believe is very powerful. It's one that I've implemented myself. So many times we want to do big changes, like for the new year. We're like, okay, I'm gonna go to the gym every day. I'm gonna spend 2 hours in the gym. I'm gonna work out until, you know, I'm about to faint. And you know what happens? Everyone rushes into the gym in January. By February and March, there's plenty of parking spaces out. There are plenty of machines in the gym that aren't being used because people have fallen off the wagon. And so this technique helps you to not fall off the wagon. So you want to pick one thing you can do, a simple thing you can do every day to support your goal. And so that's your action plan. And so you're going to look at the image every day. You're going to think about, imagine this happening, imagine your goal happening in your mind while you're doing some type of physical activity, and it could be as simple as running in place. And the third thing you're going to do is make one simple change, a small change that supports your goal that you can do every day. Now, if you do this for 1 week, you implement this action plan for 1 week, you will notice a difference in your life. You will notice a change. You will feel a change. And you will feel your courage muscle building, and you'll feel more momentum as you move towards your goal. I really enjoy sharing this information with you because I know this information will just spark something in your life and will encourage you to really show up authentically and live a life that's more fitting to who you are. I know that you've enjoyed this information too. I've been reading all of your emails and your messages, and I'm just so grateful to bring this information to you, and so grateful that so many of you are responding in such positive ways. I've always said that courage should be taught in schools. So many people believe the myth that courage is either something you're born with or something you don't have. Either you have it or you don't. And I just don't believe that. I believe we're all born with the seed of courage. And if we nurture it, and if we water it, and we help it grow within us, that we can lead more courageous lives. When people ask me how I'm able to accomplish things that look courageous to them, I'm always so surprised because it doesn't feel courageous to me. It feels natural. It feels like the next natural step in who I am. And so the actions just flow from who I am, and it doesn't feel like I'm taking this big, huge, courageous leap. It really is an invaluable skill that will help us throughout our whole lives when we learn to break through, when we learn to not allow our fears to stop us, when we learn to support ourselves into making big leaps and daring greatly to be who we were called to be. I really have been studying courage for over 20 years. Every time that I've been introduced to a world leader that I just thought was fascinating, I wanted to know how they did it. How did they go from being ordinary to really having a great impact in the world? What was their secret? What was it that they did? What was it that they knew? What was it that they learned in order to show up bigger in the world? Everyone who's ever achieved something great has had a transition. They started out normal, just like you and me. But something happened where they learned something and they figured something out and they were able to be greater. And I believe that we can all mimic that transition in our own lives. We can all learn that secret and learn to show up bigger in the world. You know, this hasn't always been my life. And I shared my story in the first video about how I lived this life that looked from the outside like I had it all together, but I hated my life. And hate is a strong word, but now that I know better, now that I know all that life could be, I was really just disappointed with my day-to-day life. And it wasn't a bad life, don't get me wrong. I worked for a great company, I worked with great people, and you know, some of these people I still talk to today, so it wasn't a bad life. It was just a life. It wasn't the life that I always imagined for myself. It wasn't the artistic life. It wasn't the life where I felt like I was given my gifts. It wasn't the life that I feel like I was meant to live. It was my safe life. It was my plan B life. And so I know how scary it is to break out of that life and to really live the life you were called to live. When I first decided to leave my safe corporate life, I was terrified. And I had to go through a process to get over that fear and to really step out on faith. And this happened again for me when I was a massage therapist and I had a lucrative career. My daughter was 1 year old and you know, I had a family that I was helping to support and bring money into the household. I had a home that had a mortgage that needed to be paid. I had a second home that had tenants in it, but sometimes the tenants paid their rent and sometimes the tenants didn't pay their rent. So I had two mortgages that I was responsible for overall. And it was scary when I first realized that I, in order to live my life's purpose, I would have to walk away from my massage practice. I know what it feels like to feel like you have to stay where you are because people depend on you, because you have responsibilities. I know what it feels like to live a life that is less than what you deserve because you feel like it's the only way that you can meet the responsibilities that you have. The idea of starting over frightened me, and it almost paralyzed me to the point where I didn't know if I could move forward. But you know what scared me more than the idea of starting over? What scared me more was just thinking of my daughter and thinking that one day she would be faced with the same decision. Does she take the safe route? Or does she take the route that may be uncertain and unsure, but that will lead to her living her highest potential and giving her highest gifts to the world? And the thought that she would choose the safe route because it's all she's ever seen before. It's all she's ever known. It's what she saw mommy do. It's what she saw daddy do. The idea that she would be this terrified as I was in that moment, that she would be that terrified to live her dreams was enough to make me move forward. It was enough to make me say, you know what, no matter what I feel, I have to show my children what it's like to live your best life. I'm gonna be honest with you, this isn't an easy thing to do. It wasn't easy for me to do, and it's just not easy to do. It's not easy to look at your life and say, you know what, I'm not happy here. And I wanna devote myself to creating a life that actually makes me happy. I wanna devote myself to giving, because I know if you're watching this video, the dream that you have for your life involves giving back to the world, because that's how I am. I can't feel satisfied in life just making money. I can't feel satisfied in life just having my own business. I have to know that I'm having a positive impact on the world. And I know that there's a group of people I know that there's a group of people you think about and you can't stop thinking about them. You see them everywhere you go and you know that you have the solution to their problem. You know that you have something, an experience that you have, a lesson that you've learned. You have something to give them that will make their lives better, that will make their lives more fulfilling. That's how I feel about courage. I can't stop talking about it. I can't stop thinking about it. I dream about it. Sometimes it even keeps me awake at night. I can't stop thinking about how can I bring more courage into the world. And I know you can't stop thinking about your dream either. And if you have something inside of you that you know can impact the world in that in a powerful way, it is your responsibility. It is your duty to commit yourself to bringing that into the world. And it's not easy. If it was easy, we would all do it. If it was easy, we wouldn't have the levels of depression that we have in the world. We wouldn't have the level of people who are just moving through life with no enthusiasm, no inspiration. We wouldn't have that. The status quo wouldn't be to work a 9-to-5 job that doesn't bring you any joy. That wouldn't be the norm. But the truth of the matter is, it is the norm. And it comes a time when you have to ask yourself, do you want to be normal or do you want to be extraordinary? And let me tell you, I've been normal and I've been extraordinary. And I will tell you that living an extraordinary life has no equal. It has no equal. So I know this isn't easy. And that's exactly why I've created a course that will take you from Plan B to VIP. It is a 7-week course. It involves 7 modules in which you will learn each of the 7 steps to living your VIP life. It really dives deep and gives you worksheets. It gives you homework. It gives you questions to ask yourself. It gives you everything you need, tools and techniques, the exact ones that I've used, the exact ones that I've talked to multi-millionaires. I've talked to entrepreneurs. I've talked to socially conscious people. I've talked to people who are changing the world, leaders and artists who are making their imprint on the world. And I've asked them, what makes you live more courageously? How did you go from being normal to leading a life that's so extraordinary, the life that we all wish we could live? How did you do that? So I've packed in all of my experience, and I've packed in the experience of over 21 people who are living these amazing lives. And I put it in a way, an easy to learn way, for you to implement this into your own life. So if you're feeling like you want something bigger for yourself, if you're feeling like it's time for you to actually have a voice in this world, for you to actually have an impact on the people that you think about, the people that you know could learn from your experience, then this is the time. And I have the course to help you get there. In the next video, I'm going to be going into way more detail about exactly what this course is and exactly what you'll get from it and all of the benefits of taking this course. But for now, I just want you to know that I've come up with this solution and it hasn't been easy for me. I really had to dig deep into my own experiences and figure out what is it that I did to change my life. What is it that all of these people that I've talked to, all of these people I've read about and researched, what is it that they did to change their lives? And I've packed it into this course, and I know that this course is going to have such a positive impact on your life. If you're ready to move forward, if you're ready to step into your new life, then I know that this course is going to be for you. So I'm so excited to tell you about it and to share more information about it. For now, just know that I am going to come out with another video and it's going to tell you all about the course. Also, I do want to let you know that I'm only taking a limited amount of participants in this course because I'm giving so much of myself and I'm giving so much personal attention to each person that I can't take everybody. So if you're interested in this course, be on the lookout for the next video that comes out. I'm so grateful again to have had this time with you, to have shared some knowledge with you. Don't forget to download your worksheet and to go ahead and get started on that. And until the next video, I want you to leave me a comment below and I want you to share with me, what is your highest, biggest dream for your life? What is it that you dream about? Come out of your closet, come out of your life purpose closet, come out of your spiritual closet and share it with me and share it with the world. What is it that you dream about? What is your highest vision for your life? Leave me a comment below. Until next time, I'll see you in the next video. Please have a very blessed day. Bye.